Okay, welcome back everybody. This time we are going to be tackling the Cathedral of the Deep. We've just defeated the Crystal Siege. So first off, we're going to dump off all of these souls with the Firekeeper. And we got two levels worth. So we are going to kick our intelligence up to a nice round 25. Let's see how our spell buff stat is looking. So we're on 115, and seems like this is probably one of the lower end, because they'll say B scaling, but as you can see, that's only going 115. Social staff slightly ahead at 116, and of course with the heretic staff being at 122, meaning that by the time we get to higher levels of intelligence, we are probably going to sacrifice that point of strength to be able to use the heretic staff, because that's the gap is starting to widen as we get up to the 25 intelligence. I imagine by the time we get to 40, that number's only going to get bigger. So, oh, still got some souls. So let's go and dump those with. Our sorcery dude.
Back it up.
So what have we got left to get from you? We need the magic shield. We will buy that just for completion, because we do need to buy all of his spells.
Come again.
That gets us down to 96. As I was saying, I always like to enter a new area with as few souls as possible. I mean, I know what's coming, but not everybody will. And I am, just because I really enjoy it, going to attune Farron Flash Sword. Just for the fun. It is absolutely not required for this area. It probably won't even make anything easier. So, and here we are, just at the bonfire, just after the Crystal Siege. We've already cleared out the two NPC defenders of this area. Onward and upward. Now, as soon as you come to this, you want to hang a left behind these trees and into this trench. You do want to kind of run through some of it until you get up to this actual wall, which will help you to remain defended at least somewhat from all of the kind of crossbowmen that are firing bolts at us as we try and run over. Ouch. So you do want to try and get rid of some of this as quickly as you can, because it's just an absolute shock fest. Now you can obviously just run past all of this. If you think, oh, you know what, I can't be able to deal with all that to get what he's getting, you know, that is your fault. Feel free for that. Just around the corner there is an Estus shard which we'll be collecting. So feel free to just run on by, but for the purposes of this walkthrough, we are going to be doing our best to collect everything. There we go, we have some extra souls. So around here we will have a new type of enemy. I don't really know what to call them. Fire suicide people. So this guy here is going to set himself on fire, just run away, eventually he'll just burn himself out and die. Free souls, everybody loves free souls. Cool, so anyway, we'll just run on ahead. Open the doors and we have ourselves our first bonfire, nice and early. For some reason every area seems to have this like entrance way where you go across two bonfires right next to each other, and then that one is actually the one that gives you access to the main hub of the area. So although this is entirely different, it's still kind of the same shape as the swamp area, where it's just a big round open area on the other side of there. But you kind of just basically have to unlock all the shortcuts for this one. So, before we get caught out here, I don't actually know where he's gone. We're probably going to get ambushed now. But we're going to kill this guy, as once you get up here, he will just come and start chasing after you. Up here, you've got four guys that are praying, and as you go past them, or if you want that item, you'll have to kill them. This one is the one that you want to kill first. The reason being, he is also one of the suicide guys, and just taking him out like that will mean that you haven't got to deal with him trying to explode on you. There is our newest Esther shard. So from here you've got two routes. You have this one, which is a shortcut to a later area, and you have this one, which is the way that we're going to go, as this takes on kind of the upper path. We'll then be coming back around, hopefully doing the whole thing in one go, and unlocking ourselves a shortcut. Now, that being said, doing this can be quite difficult, so once you've got stuff, do feel free to nip back and have a rest, because you can just kind of circumvent and shortcut your way around a lot of this. So, but these enemies are not too aggressive for the most part. There are a few that have like a transformation that will not be very nice. With mentioning that, I'm just reminding myself, let's equip. Is he coming back? Right, okay, let's quickly equip a torch. We don't have a torch, so we are going to go back and acquire something once we've finished our way with being around here. Now, being as I'm not using magic weapon or anything, I'm going to switch this to the other hand, although I don't know how much more convenient it's going to be to use. Let's see if these guys are susceptible to our poison. Down there. So, those guys are already dead. They don't give a crap about our poison. So, with that being said, we're going to try out our new toy. And grab all this. Got the Executioner's Greatsword. And here we're going to have some of the ones that transform themselves. And you're going to want to just run through here, because they are quite slow. These are fine shots to try to trap you in. Oh, as you can see, I just love the Power and Crash Sword. I'm just wasting points here, just using it up. I have taken a bit of a wrong turn there. So, we are going to go this way. Now, I've just been hit, and this is where I'm going to wish I had my torch with me, and why we are going to go back and get one. As you can see, one of those guys that had that thing sticking out of his belly has just infected me with maggots. Now, that will make me bleed out twice, which is pretty damn... just not very nice. That's all I can say. It's just not very nice. Makes me want to swear. That's how it is. So yeah, there's no more items for us to grab that way. So we don't really need to bother with that. Just absolutely ignore as much of this as you can. Pick everything up on the way through. Now there's a dual-wielding lady up there, we're going to deal with her in a second. We are... wow, come on. Oh, looks like our friend is helping us out here. I don't know whether he is in fact firing at us or them. Undead Bone Shard, which is going to be useful. Is backfiring on our side, that does give me a great idea for this one, because obviously now, wow, blood loss is just disgusting. Right then, so, so yeah, we can in fact have the giant kill these enemies for us. but she's not too bad once she starts getting the hits. Although she seems to have infinite poise when she's doing her big two-handed swing, so do be careful of that. Well, as I was saying, kind of healing is an issue in this area just because of how almost long and how much stuff there is to grab. But obviously, if we die, we don't need to take the upper path anymore. We are just going to be going around. Wow, that tree was so bright, I thought I missed an item. Again, up here, we're just going to run by. And to the right, we have a tower. Now, this tower, we'll have a ladder in it. We drop the ladder down, and that will unlock a shortcut for us. Cool. And that ladder now allows us to get up this tower, should we die down those, down the drop that we looked at the beginning of the episode. So with that done, head back up this way. And across to the side. Let's check we don't miss anything around here. Okay, I hope it's not doing it for you, but for some reason my screen seems to be flickering. I'm going to have to check this out in a second once we get to the bonfire. This we will open from the other side. Here we've got bug pellets. Oh wow, I've just realised how bad this area is going to be with no healing. Okay, so at this point, being as we've cleared the upper path, I am going to homeward bone out of here. Just to reset this. Everybody, we're back. I've restarted the game to see if we can get rid of whatever it was that was making the screen flicker as we were going around the last area. I was kind of a bit desperate to kind of get out of there anyway because I needed the Estus flasks back. We have got a shard to go and use, so we're going to do that. We've got a couple of key items, and there is also the notched whip over here in the corner. And whilst we're doing that, we are also going to pick up the torch, making progress through the rest of that area a little bit more easy and a bit more kind of stomachable as we go through. So, over to Andre. Let's get ourselves an extra flask. Going to go for a Ashen Flask because we are obviously a caster, and as we start going through some more of the areas, we are in fact going to be using more and more magic, being as we are intelligence build, and that eventually will be where the majority of our damage comes from. There we go, torch.
Ashen one.
Now, back on with the cathedral we go. Sorry about this. Now, I don't actually understand what the level of the bonfire means. I assume it means it's changed stage as we progress through the game. It is something that I'm going to look into and find out about, and I will do a video about it eventually, once I know more. But it's just a guess. So, let's go. So let's equip our torch. There we go. Now, I don't know if this is going to fall us down here. Hopefully not. Now, before, obviously, we kicked the fire down. So now, going down here is a bit more of a better option. Now, these writhing things down here are going to try and give us some trouble. But they're not going to succeed. Maybe they are. Okay, so they don't cause very much damage. But obviously, the main issue is that they are putting these maggots all over us. Now, if we get this out, no more maggots! Woo! So yeah, I'm probably going to do a separate video on that specifically, so that anybody looking for what exactly is happening, because it took me a bit of time to actually notice that there were maggots all over me, and how to, you know, get rid of them. So we've got two ways around. It's basically a big circle. Either way around that you want to go. Obviously, if you did come down here, we've got this. Which leads back into the bonfire room as well. Sorry guys, it's definitely quiet right now, isn't it? Too quiet. You can see why. So, first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to go down and grab this. I don't know why I just keep letting him hit me. Cool, this should give us the poison bite ring. Yeah, which gives us some poison resistance, which may or may not come in handy later. Bit of a quick heal. We'll deal with the giant crystal lizard. Whoops. Really doesn't care about our rapier. So obviously, same as last time. He's got a bit more health, but should be fine. Try and stab his tail. Keep locked on. Try not to get caught with no stamina. Trade some blows with him. Set off through the crystal lizard. I'm gonna have missed it thanks to you. Thought we got the Titanite scale. Nope, he hasn't gone. Okay. So we're gonna go and grab you. Oh, what? What? Ah! Yeah, into the corner. Titanite! And then we're gonna have another one over on the left in a second. Is that clear around our circle? Over here for some more Titanite shards. So we're looking pretty good for Titanite shards. We may actually upgrade the shield soon. Now, in fact, I'll talk about that later. Let's not get too sidetracked as we're trying to actually get through the game, eh? Because it's fun. Oh, oh, oh. Hey, I want some fun. These guys don't know what being staggered means. Even if they don't do much damage. Nice that they give quite a few souls though. That's 660 each, and they're not that threatening. And away with the bleed build up. Cool, so we've gone around full circle. And if you are feeling like you are low on Estus at this point, feel free to go and grab a heal, because essentially, obviously, we've gone around full circle, we've collected almost everything we're going to collect from here, we've just got to go up there to grab that item. And, you know, you can literally just go back through there to... what's the word? Replenish your healing, and we are obviously carrying quite a few souls from killing all of the enemies around here, so you may not want to chance losing it, but I'm quite confident that I can get round to the next place before I die. Although some of it may have to be a speed run through. So, yeah. And plus, obviously, if I die, I'll just cut back for you guys just so you can see the direction that we're going in. Right, where's that tower gone? I'm getting myself lost here. Right, so we're going to go down this way. Yeah. So, just so that I haven't gotten everybody lost just there, that's the bit where we dropped down from. You come along here, up to the right, and up this ladder. So, essentially, you can come up here without even having fought any enemies whatsoever. Thereby meaning that you have got all 8 of your healing Estus flasks, or 9, or even 10, depending on kind of how you are setting your Estus flasks up. Just have to be aware that we are going to have the Lady Dancer in here somewhere. Where is she? We do want to deal with her on our own if we can. Or we could just sneak past her. That's equally good for me. So, just so that you know, the lighter your armour is, the less noise it makes, and that does in fact make a difference when it comes to kind of walking past enemies and going unnoticed and stuff. There is a whole stealth element to this game. Although it's not necessarily fantastic, that could be pretty devastating if that dual wielding sword person comes up right now, as you can no longer heal. So do be careful with these guys. Come on. Cool, that'll do. So the only reason we were really hiding there was because this guy was up in this little tower where we couldn't really reach him whilst we were dealing with these guys. I mean, we could fire some spells up, but you'll have issues with these guys all trying to spawn onto you. So, let him kill himself. Hey! Again with the extra Estus flask. I don't understand what causes this. So, him right there, he is literally there just to make your life not very nice. But, Soul Greatsword can go through walls in either of its variants, so feel free to use that to your advantage. Now, if you look up, we should. I can't see him right now, but we should be able to see some more of those little hooded enemies that like to jump down and ambush you. There we go, there's one. I'll deal with you. His friend's gonna jump down? Doesn't look like it. He will get up when you try and grab that item. That is like a massive trap area. There should be some more of them somewhere. Come on. I was kind of hoping he'd catch his friend there. That's you down. And another one. These guys just like to keep on coming. So I'm going to make an attempt to do all of this place in one go so they don't have to come back later. There is quite a lot to find and collect, and there are multiple kind of ways through this area, so feel free to kind of watch where we go, watch where all the access points are, and kind of feel what you find easier rather than just doing it the way that I do it. I always say Dark Souls is about finding your own way through the challenges rather than copying somebody else's. But you are going to want to come down here at a fairly decent speed so that we can take a couple of these out rather than getting hit by them. You've then obviously got the spear guy and the archer again. Uh, And it's like not really the damage of the bolts, it's the interruptions when you're trying to fight stuff that make them an issue. And as soon as you start trying to attack one of the archers, he will aggro on you even more, although he damages them because they can heal there. That is kind of where your issue comes in, and you just have to take your opportunities as they come. So I think that there is the path of progression, so we're going to check up here first. Now there's a couple of nooks and crannies and a few traps around this way. So going over there we have the fat lady, and up here we have got some of the little guys, so we're going to want to go in there and then just roll straight out. So again, you see, nipping back and healing is an absolute option here, because we're now in another optional area which is going to take even more healing from us. So you weren't poisonable before, were you? So we are just gonna bomb you. Whoa! Roll backwards, roll backwards. We're in a bad situation right now. Get down. Oh, getting a bit tense there. To here, to the firebomb. Are you gonna set yourself on fire as well? Look like you might have done just then. Under hunt charms. So that's that bit taken care of. And then we have this bit. Now I don't think there's very much up there, so there's no need to kind of get up there. As you see at the top there's a fence. So you're basically taking the risk of dying to what you can do is obviously spring this ambush early, and thereby save yourself some of the effort that we were doing earlier. But the way that we did it earlier was a little bit easier in my eyes. I'll take you on. With us being low on heals, we are now going to try and keep some distance between us and some of the enemies until they're like close to death, so that we can take them out clearly as safely as we can. Let's use one of these. As always, another trap. It's actually quite funny how these guys try to use the lock-on against you to make you turn away from what you're meant to be facing. Whoa. Damn. These little guys, I feel like, are more lethal than they should be. Cool. And that is not even the end of the ambush yet. We have another one up there with the Flamberge. We are going to spot him first and take care of that. Obviously we are in quite a bad position in terms of dying. Now these guys are both the kind of guys that are going to want to set themselves on fire, so be careful of those. I'm sure I just heard something trying to throw something at me. Let's get rid of you. Obviously with that last couple of points of intelligence, our spells do seem to be doing considerably more damage now. He's trying to stop us from healing. So we'll wait for that to wear off. Now up here we've got two of the dancer ladies, but we should be able to get them to come at us one at a time, if I remember rightly. I think she's come to us, yeah. Now, there is a leash point somewhere. I can't can't remember where it is. But we're going to use that to our advantage right now. Still following us? No. Yes, no, yes. The movements are so awesome. Okay, so it looks like you will follow me forever. Interesting. But the rapier. Just the rapier. Right then, hopefully we'll meet this. So back through we go. It sounds like something still throwing something at me somewhere. Wait. What? How did you throw that at me? Hacks, I tell you. Right, and so through on to the next bit, where we have should have another sword dancer lady. There we go. Hopefully, try and bomb you before you can get to me. Ouch. Quite funny. Wow. So either they updated the AI, or that was just like incredible fluke on the AI's part just there when it tried to bait me into a backstab, and then kind of flew out of it. Now, should be an item around here somewhere. I feel like I'm missing something. Are you guys gonna set yourselves on fire? Yes. Just gonna wait for those. So let's push on. We've got quite a big trap ahead as well. Still dead. So we should be getting close to one of the shortcuts now, if I remember rightly. So. Yeah. So basically what we need to do is get through there, under that, down there, run through the hallway, down the bottom, and that opens the elevator. Okay. So at this point it is in fact quite far to the shortcut that gets us into the bonfire. So I'm unsure what to do right now. Stuff it, let's push on. We'll be fine. Won't we? Death. That is so gonna be a death. Let's at least make this reachable if I am going to die. Oh, you're unleashed there, are you? That's fine with me. So, if like me you are struggling for healing right now, there's nothing wrong with nipping back to the bonfire, healing yourself, and then coming back through. Obviously knowing that we did go through a couple of side areas, which we wouldn't then have to do on the next go through of this area. This part actually included, because obviously we don't need to spring this ambush the next time we come through here. But I am going to try to press this on as far as I can get. The other thing that will give us an advantage the next time we come through this is the fact that we do also have an undead bone shard, which will mean that our Essence Flasks will heal for more. And there we have an ember. Now, another thing to note, if you are not already embered, you can use an ember to heal yourself back to full health for like a last-ditch effort to get yourself to whichever shortcut it is that is close to you. There's none above us, so we're going to run straight past this. Any enemy on the right? No. Now that there is a trap. I think it's like an item degradation trap, or it's a poison. And obviously right now we cannot afford to poison, because we will just simply die from it. Two pyromancers. Ooh. Can't afford to be getting hit by flames either. And onto the lift. Now, if what I'm thinking is correct, this should hopefully take us to a shortcut back to the fire, back to the bonfire, which it has done. Yes, so just in time. That brings us back to the bonfire, where we can joyously restock on everything. So we are going to nip back to the final shrine and spend our souls that we've just acquired, because we did actually get quite a lot going through there. We did quite a lot in one go. So after this there'll be a small cut where I check how long it is, and decide whether or not we're going to carry on with this in one video or whether we'll go for a bit longer. So, with our next 5 levels, let's go for... We do need to start getting tuned up. So we can have some extra spells equipped. And we do need more endurance. So, I think we're going to go for 2 attunement. Let's get that nice and even at 20. And then we'll put 2 in endurance and 1 in intelligence. That will get us to 40.
Farewell,
mate. We've already given you ashes.
Ashen one.
Okay. See if we've got any goodies for you. We should have some pyromancy scrolls for Mr. Cornix over here. He gives us a free pyromancy flame, which we can reinforce if we wish to.
Yes.
And then he has got all of this. We will buy flash sweat right now. That will become more apparent later.
Do not be gone.
Go and speak to Grey Rat.
Heavens. Heavens.
Oh dear.
Heavens.
So, that's given us a gesture. When we come back to him next time, we should be able to go and send him out to do some more stealing. And now teleportation back to the cleansing chapel. I just remember I didn't even use the bone, but it should be fine anyway. I'll use the bone shard next time. You guys can go ahead and do that. So, with that being said, I'm going to have a quick check on how long we are so far. I don't really want it to go too far above half an hour. As I'm sure you guys by now are probably bored of listening to me rambling on as we're going through that area. So, I'll either cut back in a second or we will be in the next video. See you in a moment.